Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us. My name is Daniela Roos. I'm the director of MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory. And so to get us started, please welcome MIT President Sally Kornbluth.
Morning, everyone. I'm really happy to see everyone here. And hello to all the people who came from far and wide, and also to our MIT community. I want to thank Daniela, who you just saw, Cynthia Brazil, and Sertaj Karaman for making this amazing symposium happen. And thank you all for being here to help kick off day one of MIT's Generative AI Week. In this gathering of generative AI experts, I want to be very, very clear about one thing. I am not one. And so, but one of my favorite things about the MIT community is the incredible spirit of openness and intellectual generosity. So I'm looking forward to learning a tremendous amount today. You know, I happen to be a cell biologist, but if I'm curious about how generative AI might affect my discipline or any other discipline, I just start asking questions, and very quickly I find myself in conversation with some of the most brilliant and innovative people in the field. Today's events and the symposia to follow are designed to showcase that brilliance and innovation that's MIT. We have a global audience today, and as always, we are delighted to share our work with the world. But I also see this event as a crucial opportunity for cross-pollination within the Institute. The idea is for everyone here to get a full spectrum of generative AI topics and questions that people are pursuing here on our campus. I know that we can count on fascinating panels and speakers today, but to me, the most important measure of success will be the introductions, the conversations, and the collaborations that will certainly blossom after this event. So whatever your particular interest, if you hear something you want to understand more deeply, if you sense some cool new intersection with your own ideas that you have not encountered before, or if you feel inspired to invite someone to collaborate with you, please don't be shy. Ask questions, introduce yourself. The true purpose of the gathering is to generate creative collisions between people and ideas in the very, very best spirit of MIT. So the structure of today's discussions reflects three crucial realms in which the people of MIT are and have been engaged in this burgeoning field. They've helped build GenAI's intellectual foundations, they're advancing its applications, and they're exploring its ethical dimensions and its societal implications and impacts. Now, as many of you know firsthand, the campus has been buzzing with generative AI activities for many months. For instance, this fall, we funded seed grants for 27 faculty projects to accelerate research on how AI will transform people's lives and work. Because the enthusiasm was so broad and so overwhelming, we've already called for a second round of proposals. The MIT Work of the Future Initiative is using real-world data to think about how AI might create better jobs and allow workers to help drive innovation instead of being driven out of their work by it. A few weeks ago at an event called MIT Ignite, which I was very happy to attend, students and postdocs offered compelling ideas for AI entrepreneurship, from mental health to drug discovery to immigration to education. It was really just a dazzling array of fantastic ideas. And through a partnership with Harvard called Axum Collaborative, MIT is exploring educational aspects of Gen AI that could help underserved students reach their full potential. The range and depth of all of this work is truly fantastic. MIT is building a whole new reputation for itself as the Massachusetts Institute of the Impact of Technology. We are focused on how these technologies are going to impact the world. And in that spirit, I want to highlight another area where MIT is working to make a crucial difference in helping to inform and shape policies and regulation around Gen AI, regulations that will shape the future for all of us, both here at home and around the globe. Working closely with MIT's Washington office, faculty experts developed a policy paper specifically geared to help leaders in Congress and government agencies understand the norms, the regulations, and the institutions that it will take to ensure a future in which we contain the societal risks of generative AI and make sure that its advances are broadly beneficial. In this case, the stakes are too high to just try stuff and observe the outcomes. We need to make sure that sensible regulation is built in right from the start. With any new technology, one mark of a successful regulatory regime is that it inspires a productive industrial research agenda. Just as calls to make cars safer inspired automakers to develop seatbelts, airbags, lane sensors, and anti-lock brakes, we need the commercial players who are also partnering on the development of generative AI to join us in the project of making sure that it will lead society to exciting new destinations without driving us all right over a cliff. In this work, as with ChatGPT itself, the quality of the results we achieve will be dependent upon the quality of the questions that we ask. So let's act as if we're a community of intensely creative people with unusual technical insight, charged with helping a late-stage capitalist society plan to safely integrate a rapidly advancing new technology in ways that are humane and broadly beneficial, that help solve urgent problems, and that usher in an era of shared prosperity. I honestly cannot think of a challenge more closely aligned with MIT's mission. It is a profound responsibility, but I have every confidence that we can face it if we face it head on and we face it together as a community. So thank you very much. I hope you have a wonderful time at the symposia, attendant symposia. And at this moment, I will turn it back over to Daniela, who has done a wonderful job working with her colleagues getting this mobilized. So thank you.
Thank you, Sally. The MIT community is deeply appreciative for your leadership and support of generative AI. By initiating so many exciting programs, by finding the financial resources and creating a space where ideas can take flight and collaborations can thrive, your foresight is indeed helping the MIT community in laying the groundwork for a future that is bright and innovative.